today we have had a super chill fun day. We went to Tizo, which is like an outdoor shop in there's loads of them, and we also went for a walk and did a bunch of other things. But now I am back home, 23 minutes past 5. I'm making some dinner. I made like a curry last night, just like it was like a carrot type curry that I made, and I'm heating up some rice for that. So I thought while I do that, I'll make a lemon drizzle cake, which is one of our favourite sugar-free, well, refined sugar-free desserts to make, that is so enjoyable but also really nutritious as well. So I'll put the recipe in for you to try, but this is something I often do whenever I've got extra lemons or I've got the ingredients for, I'll make one of these, and they're really good for breakfast and stuff like that as well. So yeah, let's go on to it. Sugar-free desserts can be and are absolutely fantastic, especially if you are not eating much sugar or if you've gone a little bit of time without having much refined sugar. They just taste amazing. And the recipe that I'm making here is called the lemon drizzle, which I think I said already, and it's from a Deliciously Ella book. And to be honest, I'm not a super recipe person. Like, I usually just go off what my mind is thinking and on previous recipes, or if I'm trying something new, I'll follow a recipe, but I always edit it. So it's a bit unnatural for me to completely follow a recipe, but this recipe is so good. It's so enjoyable, and it's I don't know how to explain it. It's just done really, really well for a sugar-free recipe. So it's sugar, well, it's refined sugar-free, and it's also vegan, but the way that we make it isn't vegan because I add normal milk. But you can easily make this recipe vegan, which is amazing, and it is absolutely delicious. You must try this one. It's honestly such a good recipe. So check out the description box for that one, of course. All of these are in the description. But this is great for breakfast, for a snack, for dessert. It's just a fantastic recipe and you should definitely try it.
I'll never get a break from being on camera.
That's no good. I'm meeting my friend Denise for a drink.
Denise, do I know Denise?
Yeah, you know, my old girlfriend.
Oh my god, gross. I can't even picture you with a woman. Thank you.
Hey, I'm
Mom. I do. The next sugar-free dessert that's on the list is banana bread. And of course, it's a classic. Banana is a really great way to sweeten things. But it's probably one of the more oldest, well, the older sugar-free kind of dessert slash sweet things that I had right in throughout the journey, so I thought it was only right to share with you guys, and it's always a favourite and a classic, so let's do it. Like I said, there's a little bit of a history with this recipe. This is like a really old BBC Good Food recipe, and I'm not even sure if it's the same as the recipe anymore. Like, I just make this exact same thing every time, and it's been so long that I don't even remember if it is the exact same or not. But basically, my mum used to make this, and she, quick backstory, she stopped eating sugar a long time ago, but she's kind of gone back and forward with it. But she made quite a lot of these types of recipes at the start, which got me kind of making them as well. And obviously banana bread's a classic, everyone likes banana bread, but this one specifically doesn't have any added sugar and it doesn't need it. If you add bananas, especially super ripe ones, you just have absolutely no problems when it comes to sweetness. Especially with the raisins as well, it's super good with the raisins. And again, this is another one that's it's really healthy. Like, you can have it for breakfast, you can have it for whenever, it doesn't really matter. It has loads of fibre, loads of nutrients, and it's just a really nice snack, breakfast, or dessert.
It ruffles me when some goobers tell me I have to spend half my payday on their hot dogs.
Our next dessert is a little bit more involved, but I might have found a quick way of doing it. So I'm going to get the weekly shop and I'll show you what dessert that we're going to be making. Bring my food.
Have you got your food? Have you got the water? You got water?
No.
Do we eat water?
No. Okay, that is all the food shop acquired. Talk over this voiceover because, well, this video, because in this video I have absolutely no idea that the washing machine is blaring the whole time. I'm not even joking, you can hardly hear me. Honestly, I don't know what I was thinking. But in this video, basically, if you guessed what I was making from the mascarpone there, it would be tiramisu. And this recipe is more of like a showstopper. It's one of probably like a one is something you're going to make if you're making a nice dinner or you want to make like a special thing. So these on the screen now are ladyfingers, and you've probably heard of them before, but if you haven't, that's what they are. They're basically like crispy sponge, sponge things with loads of sugar over it. And I never thought that you could make tiramisu without those, or I didn't really know what else you could put instead. So last week I made this with sponge. So I made a sponge and then let it cool and chopped it up like ladyfingers. And that's how I did it sugar free. But this time I actually used sourdough bread that you just saw in that video and took the crusts off and used that instead of the sponge or the ladyfingers. And you'll see how it goes, but this is a much quicker way of doing it. And one that's kind of made the process go a lot smoother as well. So I'm really happy I tried that, because you can definitely use bread for this as long as it's not, you know, too specific in taste.
Okay, let's go.
Fun fact, you do not need alcohol for a tiramisu. I used to work for an Italian woman and, well, a couple of Italian women, and they said you did not need to put alcohol in tiramisu, and it's often a westernized way of making tiramisu. So I don't drink alcohol anyway, but it's not really something I would buy to put in this, so I don't put any alcohol in tiramisu. And basically this is such a good recipe. It's really, really like the one that the Italian woman I used to work for would make, and that's what I really like about it, because I think you get such a variety of tiramisu online. Okay, now we've had the big guns in, to the test. Yes! But apart from that, make sure you fold it at this point, by the way. It should say that on the recipe, but it looks like I'm beating it and I'm not. But the bread worked really well. It was really interesting that it did actually work. It just soaked up the coffee really well. And I think it did have less of a sweet taste, but it tended to work really well. But I really love this recipe, you should definitely try it. Okay, we've been out for a run and back now, all showered. Don't mind the hair. And my tiramisu is marinating in the fridge right now. I'll show you it in a second, but I'm going to make some dinner and then I'm going to put some cacao on the top of that tiramisu and I'll show you how it is going and how it tastes. So this is what it's looking like. It is looking like tiramisu and it looks really good, so I'm excited. Seconds. What did you say? You want to polish it off?
Yeah, but I'm not gonna.
Save some for breakfast tomorrow.
Yeah, I'm gonna try. It's not looking great though, I've not left that much. Oh, just another decent sized serving.
Mm. all sugar free. So we had three really good recipes that were sugar free that you can try in this video. I really hope you enjoyed it. I have all the ingredients and the recipes down below in the description. Please do let me know if you try any of these and if you liked them, and also please do like the video and subscribe for more content like this. Check out my other videos as well. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll speak to you guys next week.